starting to really understand why you're in business is going to really help dictate the budget, your financial path, and what decisions you're making. So I will definitely say, I know we didn't talk about that at the beginning of this, but kind of bringing it full circle, really understanding that will help dictate you. If you told me, right, if I came in as a consultant on the business and you said, I want to grow consistently every single year for this reason, I'm going to build a budget that's completely different if you said, I want to scale at all cost and I want to get to this number in 3 years because I have a different outcome. I'm going to allocate your resources completely different. I'm going to say, okay, if you want to scale at all cost, profit's not a number we need to worry about. We need to reinvest in the business. It's going to go into these categories and we need to hit these numbers. If you tell me I want to grow and I want to hire X amount of people per year and keep them happy and be comfortable, and that's a whole different budget. So when you're building out this budget, really make sure you understand what the goal is of your business, because that will dictate how much in each bucket you should be targeting. So I think that's a big key piece that a lot of people don't discuss. That's a harder conversation to have with yourself, but you should really sit on it and think, because that'll help you plan for next year.
That's also the first thing you should be talking about when you sit down with whoever you're working with marketing. That's the first question we ask. Why? What do you want to do? What's the goal? What's the plan? I'll tell you, that's also the hardest question he asks me all the time. And pressures me on, like, rock solid. He's like, why? What do we want to be? What's the 3-year plan? What's the 5-year plan? What's the 10-year plan? And he's constantly pressuring and asking the why. But like he said, if I get on the call with father-son duo, and they've already worked in a large business and don't want the stress and they just want to make $500,000 a year and call it a day, great. That's a different marketing strategy. That's a different budget. That's a different forecast. That's a different plan. So if I want to hand it over to my kids, I want my daughter to have this is her legacy, this is her baby, and I want her to be able to run this company, that's a different plan. If I want to be able to put it up and grab 7X from a PE 5 years from now and start over in a new state, that's a different plan.
Yeah, I think it all goes back to what's your goal, what's your why. Depending on that, you'll start to understand where to spend. This goes back to, let me see if I can go back a little bit. This goes back to these categories right here, right? These are benchmarks. These are great benchmarks for a stable, scaling, comfortable business with a nice profit margin on the end of it. But if you're retaining 25% profit, how much are you really putting back in the company to scale? How much are you really growing it? There's a fine balance. And if you say, I want this company to be double next year, a 25% profit margin is a lot harder to achieve, because realistically, you should be allocating a lot more money into marketing and staffing and paying for investments in technology to scale successfully. And so you have to figure out what that looks like, because 25 is that it's not a realistic number. And then you need to change your targets so that you're not banging your head against a wall saying, why am I not hitting 25? Because it's impossible. You're trying to double your business. If you're saying, we're already consistent and I just want to do this every single day for the rest of my life because I like where I'm at and I want 25%, this is a benchmark for you. So have those conversations, because these will change.